Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to another video. So in today's video, I'll be showing you how to find out which Apex classes have implemented an interface and after finding what we can really do with that information. So let's explore this with some examples. So here I am in my Salesforce org and let me go to my developer console. So start with, this is a very basic interface that I've created, public interface vehicle and only one function, which is string operate where. Now I have this abstract class transportation. Under this abstract class, I have multiple classes, which all are concrete class. And all these three classes have actually implemented the interface vehicle. This is the interface and all these classes have implemented the vehicle. The first is ship and the operate function returns water because ship operates in water. So the next class is airplane and the operate where returns air. And the third class is car where operate where method returns road. With that, let me go to my function, which is transport controller. And there is a function called execute. What this function is basically doing, it's trying to find out with this query, which are the Apex classes that has implemented the interface vehicle. So the query comes from this one, ApexTypeImplementor. So this ApexTypeImplementor is a new one which is coming up with Spring 23 release. It is now GA, generally available, and it has been updated since the beta release. It represents the Apex classes that directly or indirectly implement an interface. And as you can see, using a SQL query, this object gets information about all the public and global classes that has implemented the interface. So what I'm doing here, I'm executing an SQL query where the interface name is my interface name, which is vehicle, and IsConcrete is true. I will come to this IsConcrete one, but this SQL query is returning me a list. And then what I'm doing, I'm iterating through the list and trying to find out the class name and the class name prefix. So let's go ahead and execute first. So that's my outer class, and then I want to do an execute. So let's do that. Open the log, and as you can see here, the three classes which has implemented the interface are ship, airplane, and the car. Ship, airplane, and the car. So now let's go back and understand what is this IsConcrete one. To understand that, let me go to my transportation class and let me copy that and create one more method. This time, I want to make this method as abstract class and let's say train and train track. Now, let's copy this one and execute this in our query editor. And let's execute the query. As you can see, this table contains all the classes where the vehicle has been implemented, but it's showing true for first three and showing false for the last one. Because for the last one, which is train, I made this class as abstract. So for all the concrete classes, the IsConcrete will be true. For the abstract class, the IsConcrete will be false. That's what this IsConcrete all about. Now let's play a little bit. Let's say I want to create an instance of the class that implements the interface and execute the method. How can we do that? So basically what I'm trying to do, I'm going to create an instance of the class that implements the interface and finally execute the method inside the class. So to do that, I will start from here. And here what I'm going to do, vehicle is my interface. I'm going to do a typecast vehicle and then type for this font name. The namespace will be single dot this one. Class name is this one. And then I want to create an instance. So it will be new instance. Once I get an instance, what I'm going to do, I'm going to execute the method. And here I'm going to execute the method with RS dot. What is the name of my method? This is operate where. Let's save that. And this time try to execute again. Open the log. And as you can see, this we already know. This is basically coming from this line. But this is something that we have written recently. And what it's basically doing, it is executing the method inside the concrete class, which has implemented the interface. So for example, when we are running the ship, this is returning water. When we are running airplane, this is returning air. When we are running car, it's running road. It's all coming from this line, like water, air, and road. So this is a way how you can understand which Apex classes have implemented interface and take action accordingly. So I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and please share, and also please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.